Good morning, children. So, students, in the previous chapter, we began the chapter number 2 of civics, in which we studied about parliament. We studied about the role of parliament in the government, and today we are going to discuss that topic in detail, students. We are going to understand the role of parliament one by one. So, let's see. So, children, once elected, the candidates who become the members of parliament, all the MPs together form up the parliament. And once elections to the parliament take place, the parliaments need to perform the following functions. So, very first one is to select the national government. So, children, the parliament of India consists of the president, the Rajya Sabha, and the Lok Sabha. Let's study about them in more detail. So, children, once the Lok Sabha elections are done, a list is prepared in which the number of MPs belonging to each political party is prepared. Now, as we studied in the previous segment, that the political party that covers the maximum number of seats is making the government, and the other one is known as the opposition party. So, children, one of the most important function of the Lok Sabha is to select the executive. You all are aware of the executive. Executive kaun hote hain? The one who implement the laws. It is the group of persons who work together to implement the laws which are made by the parliament. So, this executive is often what we have in mind when we use the term government. Next, children, the Prime Minister of India is the leader of the ruling party in the Lok Sabha. Lok Sabha ke andar jo majority party hoti hai, usme se we select a leader, that is the Prime Minister of India. And from the MPs who belong to the party, the Prime Minister selects to work with her to implement decisions. And children, these ministers then take the charge of different functions, that can be education, that can be finance, that can be health, and so many different areas. Then children, often in the recent past, it has been difficult for a single political party to get the majority. Then they join together with different political parties. Now let's take an example ki there is no majority party. Kisi bhi party ko more than half number of votes nahi mile. Koi bhi party jo hai wo majority nahi gain kar pai. To us situation mein kya hota hai ki two of the parties, they collide together. Wo kya karti hai? They join together. और उस जॉइंट गवर्नमेंट को क्या बोला जाता है? कोलिजन गवर्नमेंट. सो व्हेन टू डिफरेंट पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज हु आर इंटरेस्टेड इन सिमिलर कंसर्न्स, दे जॉइन हैंड्स टुगेदर, फॉर्म अप द मेजॉरिटी एंड मेक द गवर्नमेंट. एंड सच अ गवर्नमेंट इज नोन एज कोलिजन government. Then children, this was about Lok Sabha. Now let's discuss about Rajya Sabha. So Rajya Sabha, children, functions primarily at the representative of the states of India in the parliament. The Rajya Sabha, it starts the legislation, and a bill which is required to pass through Rajya Sabha in order to become the law. Koi bhi aisa decision that is taken in the Lok Sabha, it is required to be passed by Rajya Sabha to become a law. Isliye it has an important role in reviewing and altering the laws which are made by the Lok Sabha. They check the laws and they make the necessary changes required. The members of Rajya Sabha, children, are elected by the elected members of legislative assemblies. The members of legislative assembly, they only elect the members of Rajya Sabha. Now, moving on to the second role, the second function of parliament, that is to control, guide and inform the government. So, children, the parliament, while in session, begins with the question R. Now, what is the question R? So, question R is an important mechanism, children, through which MPs, they can share the information about the working of the government, in which they all collect together and they share the information about how the government is working. So this is a very important way, children, through which the parliament controls the executive, ki jo laws banaye ja rahe hain, up to what extent the government is checking those laws. And by asking the questions, the government, they get to know about the shortcomings and make the necessary changes required. Or इसके अंदर चिल्ड्रन जो ऑपोजिशन पार्टी है, दी ऑपोजिशन पार्टी दे प्ले अ क्रूशियल रोल बिकॉज दे ऑलवेज ट्राई टू शो, दे ऑलवेज ट्राई टू हाईलाइट दी ड्रॉबैक्स, दे ऑलवेज ट्राई टू हाईलाइट दी डेफिशिएंसीज मेड बाय दी रूलिंग पार्टी. मूविंग ऑन टू दी नेक्स्ट रोल, नेक्स्ट फंक्शन, दैट इज लॉ making. So law making, it is the significant function of parliament. It is the most important function of parliament to make laws according to the needs and wants of the citizens. Moving on to the next topic children, that is the next question that arises is who are the people in parliament. A parliament ke andar kaun se people, who are the people who are there in the parliament. So children, parliament now has more and more people from different backgrounds, like we have rural people also, we have backward class people also. So we have so many people from different backgrounds, groups and peoples that were till now unrepresented, the one whom we do not even knew are now beginning to get elected to the parliament. So now there has been an increase in the political participation from the Dalits and backward classes also. And children, it has been observed that the representative democracy cannot produce a perfect reflection of the society. Now there is a realization that when interest and experiences separate us, it is important to ensure that communities that have been historically marginalized, the communities which have remained backward, they also get proper representation in government. So keeping this thing in mind, keeping this view in mind, so that the backward classes can also get equal representation in the parliament, we have reserved some of the seats for SCs and STs. This has been done so that the MPs selected from these constituencies can also be familiar with the one who represent Dalit and Adivasis in parliament, so that the government can get to know about the needs and the problems of Dalits and Adivasis also. And similarly children, it has more recently been suggested that there should have been reservation of seats for the women, and it is an issue, and it is issues of this kind that force the country to ask difficult and often unresolved questions about whether our democratic system is representative enough or not. Aur isi tarah ki situations ye question arise karti hain ki we say that we have a representative democracy, but are the people, are all the societies of our country being represented in the government? And the fact that we can ask these questions and are working towards answer is a reflection of the strength and the faith that the people have in India in a democratic form of government. हमारे यहाँ पे democratic form of government है, इसीलिए हम इस तरह के questions पूछ सकते हैं. तो this is the thing which shows people's faith, people's trust in democracy.